Firefighters just cannot catch a break in north central Nebraska. Wildfire jumped the lines again tonight.
At daybreak today, the fire perimeter included nearly 200 square miles of Nebraska territory, an area up to 18 miles east to west, 11 miles north to south. Just for some perspective, that's an area about half the size of Douglas County from the riverfront west to Elkhorn.
We have the only local crew covering the fires, and KETV's Watch 7's Adrian Whitsett spent the last 2 days traveling Kippeha and Brown counties watching as the disaster got worse.
Take a drive through a wildfire. At least the parts already scorched, and you see devastation. And we're seeing plenty in north central Nebraska.
We're just reacting to whatever situation comes up.
Like the three arising Monday evening when the fire, which had been 50% contained, jumped the line.
Even from 20 miles away, you can see how much smoke there is. It's filling the canyons as part of this Fairfield Creek fire. Now, three different places that we went yesterday and today are all now under fire again.
The Nature Conservancy south of the Niobrara River had already been hit once when we drove through, but hours later it was on fire again. And much further north, the fire is threatening to cross into South Dakota because it jumped Highway 12 Monday evening. And that is the last thing residents, firefighters, and volunteers want or need.
It's been nerve-wracking. It's just hard to put into words how we really feel. I mean, it's never ending. There's no stopping this thing.
We could be doubling our efforts tomorrow if the wind comes up and makes the fire spread, or we could be cutting it in half if it doesn't hurt us and they get more of it under control today.
4 days of fighting and the battle may not even be half over. And with more days of 100-degree heat and high winds, new plans are taking shape.
So they'll coordinate both with the ground forces, talking to them about what their needs are and how we can best support them with bucket drops or other kinds of aerial resources. And then they'll also coordinate those resources in the air.
But those plans could change like the wind. Near Ainsworth, Adrian Whitsett, KETV, Newswatch 7.
And Governor Dave Heineman will tour the damage tomorrow. It's his second visit up north since the disaster started.